but you look at all the stats, amount of aces, kill ratio, it shortened the war. It was the first fighter we had that could escort the bombers to the enemy and shoot the enemy down over their own territory. So, amazing airplane, amazing.
This little jet is part of Tom Wharton's dream, because when he was a young guy, he actually saw one of those early single-seat jets, the BD-5J, like the one that flew through the barn in that James Bond movie. 1,000 hours of flight time and over 57 different types of aircraft. Let's watch it fly.
Here's what I tell everyone. I was born by God's dear grace. In an extraordinary aircraft.
With such a light jet, with over 2,000 pounds having been stripped out of the weight of the original L-39, the Super 39 has an incredible climb rate. And if you'd like to experience for yourself what it's like to see what this kind of flying is all about, make sure you stop by the Dash Pavilion to take a ride with Scott in their free virtual reality experience. You can take a ride in the back seat of the jet for this exact air show routine. Pulling back through, experiencing now five times the pull of gravity. Scott Farnsworth dives the Super 39 to show center, trading his altitude for lots more energy. As he marks the sky with his air show smoke,
jet engines. A lot of research and development went into getting rid of that smoke because it was a dead giveaway when it was approaching an aerial combat. A big round of applause for Steve Hinton.
Altitudes like this, when we're over there, you know, odds are they will probably break the sound barrier just to get to, you know, get them to drop and move out of the way.
First fighter to 50,000 feet and the first aircraft to land on a big aircraft carrier.
Got a balsa wood and plywood in it. And it actually offered some pretty significant advantages in combat, didn't it?
Yes, sir. During World War II, the Mosquito fighter bomber, they found that when 50 caliber rounds from the ground hit the airplane, it was the same destruction. It didn't kill the pilots, whereas an aluminum fuselage, the bullets would go right through.
So it's like shooting into a fat target, and it slows the rounds down significantly.
Yes, sir, and maybe does it to mind you call her a fat little girl. Followed by the Venom, the Sea Vixen, and several other twin-tail airplanes that became world famous.
And that design, you know, it was so good that a lot of other air forces around the world bought it, right?
Yes, sir. This was flown by 39 air forces across the world, and in time, until the time of the F-16, was the largest export fighter ever built.
And the F-16 came out with they're still building them today. There are over 4,500 that have been built. How many in total for the VAMP?
3,900.
And how many are still flying around the world, Jerry?
Seven.
The photo pass!
Now we're going to pull to the vertical for our thumb. We're going to push over the top. Coming straight downhill at 160 miles an hour. There's one knuckle. Two knuckles.
Man, that looks awesome. Ladies and gentlemen, so Brad Wurster can hear you in the cockpit, make some noise! Coming through at over 200 miles an hour, Brad Wurster's ahead, but here comes Mark Smith. Oh! Brad Wurster won that race. An inverted photo pass, everybody. What a race. That is absolutely fantastic. Thank you.
next to us.
And exit the flight line in a separate direction.
The Blue Angel.
Section High Alpha Pass.
Captain Doyle calls. Smoke on. Ready, break. Junction, this our 35th flight demonstration of the 2019 season.